Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the drop-down menu component to it. In general, you can use the drop-down menu to toggle between different contextual overlays that display a list of action items. You can also display text, icons, and images together on these action items. In this video, you will learn how to configure the drop-down menu component and its built-in features. I will also explain how to navigate to other web pages when a specific action item is clicked. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the drop-down menu component, I type the npm install. At Syncfusion /EJ2 React split buttons - save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, I import the drop-down button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React split buttons package. Then I include the drop-down button component tag here. To add content for the drop-down menu, I just add the content property and set its value as options. Here I want to display 5 options. For that, first I define the variable named items of type array and assign string values to the text property to display in the drop-down menu items. Then I assign this array to the items. Next, I open the app.css file and import the material theme. To align the component, I define the styles text align and padding here. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. Look here, the drop-down button component is displayed with the content options and menu items like edit, delete, mark as read, like, and share. Notice that the drop-down button items are displayed continuously. If you want to group and separate the options, use the separator property. To display a separator after the first 2 options within the items array, I simply add the separator property after the delete option and set its value to true. See the drop-down button now, the separator is shown after 2 options. Next, I will show you how to add icons for the drop-down button. To add an icon to the drop-down button, I set the icon CSS property and set the class name as eddbicons and emenu. Within the app.css file, let me define a font face with a specific source path and name its font family button icons to start accessing the required font icons for this drop-down button at the application level. Then assign the appropriate content value to access the needed menu icon. As you can see, the drop-down button is displayed with the menu icon. Notice that the menu icon is displayed at the left side of the button content. To change the button icon position, use the icon position property. To change the icon position to the top, I define the icon position property and set its value to top. Look at the icon now, it is displayed at the top of the button content. Next, I will show you how to navigate to another web page when an action item is clicked. I want to navigate to a Twitter page on clicking the share menu item. Therefore, I need to define the property URL with the appropriate link. Also, I am going to display a drop-down menu icon on the left side of the button content. So, I will set its icon position as left. See now, when I click the share option, the current page navigates to the Twitter login page. Notice that the drop-down button pop-up items are listed vertically. If I want them listed horizontally, I have to add a custom style to the CSS class property of the drop-down button component. Within the app.css file, I define the class epop-up items and add CSS styles, float, font size, padding left, and font style to it. Then I define the CSS class property and assign the defined class to it. To display list items without a separator, remove the separator property from the items. See now, when I click the drop-down arrow, the drop-down button pop-up items are displayed horizontally and without separators. By default, you can see the drop-down arrow is shown. If I want to hide this drop-down arrow, then I need to add the predefined class e-caret-hide to the CSS class property. Now, you can see in the drop-down menu that the arrow icon is hidden. Next, I will show you how to disable an item from the menu. Let's say I want to display the delete option this way. To do that, I add the disabled property in the delete option and set its value to true. You can see the delete option is now disabled. Finally, I will show you how to disable the drop-down menu. To disable the component, I just add the disabled property and set its value to true. Look, the drop-down button is now in a disabled state. In this video, I have shown you how to add the drop-down menu component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features like adding icons, displaying them in different positions, configuring different pop-up menu positions, and grouping items with separators. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.